if you are coming to me new, I'm Sarah Negus, the modern day shaman, and I'm all about energy. Not that woo-woo stuff, you know, that's sort of sits with the angels or spends all of the time out of body. I'm about focused energetic mastery. Now that comes down to using what we can learn about ourselves in the spiritual realms to further our human experience. So I use shamanic journeying and psychology together to give you a really good base and amazing tools with which to explore your own psyche. After all, you are the most important person that there is in your universe. And I want you to think about that now as we kind of sink into the idea of the not good enough wounding. Now, do tell me you're here. Do comment if you think that something I'm saying resonates with you or you want to offer an alternative view. Ultimately, everyone has their own perception. And one of my teachers once opened a whole great big workshop with the words, "This is not the truth." And I really like that. And I offer that to you now because each of us has our own truth about every single different situation or perspective that there is. And this one today is mine. And I hope that as you listen, that perhaps it will resonate with you and trigger things in you. Even if it is a negative response, that will be good because it will get you thinking. So, not good enough. That old chestnut that so many people that I come across and so many of my clients have. Now, it starts off when we're little. It starts off when we are children. And the things that we do are not kind of, we don't receive the sort of response that we expect from our parents, from our teachers, from our friends, from our grandparents. And it starts to embed the idea in our consciousness that we are less than. And in our childhood, it goes into our inner child, which is part of our shadow. And we decide, because we are young and vulnerable and emotionally immature, that we need to make amends for the fact that obviously we're not good enough because this hasn't happened as it should be. And what I did this time wasn't sort of seen by my parents as something good. You know, all of these different things. And each of us will have our own experience of not good enough. Now, what happens is that we make the decision that we're not good enough. And then through our lives, we set things up so that we can prove ourselves right. Now, at some point, you start to become aware that you think you're not worthy. And you go from having this not good enough wounding in your unconscious and being unaware of it, but living with it, to noticing. So there's four different levels, really. There's the, and I'm sure you may well have heard these levels spoken about before, but there's unconscious incompetence. Basically, you're unconscious of your patterns. So as we step into adulthood and start to really expand who we are and work into careers or parenthood or in relationships, we will be playing out unconscious beliefs that we have laid down in our psyche when we were small around the fact that we are not good enough, and therefore we have to please people, therefore we have to put ourselves last, therefore we have to overgive, or therefore we have to prove that we can. Now, all of my clients generally, no, let me think about that. Pretty much every single one of my clients on some level, men and women, will display not good enough wounding. And that's at any level. So I work with people who are beginning on their spiritual path, and I work with people that are running huge businesses, have set themselves up as entrepreneurs and are achieving 6 and 7 figures. So we're looking at the different levels, the different steps of that not good enough wounding. Now, I talked about how you start off and you're unconsciously incompetent. So you don't really know that you have this wounding. It just creates behaviors, beliefs and thought patterns in you. So perhaps you have a relationship or a friendship where, you know, your heart sinks when your friend rings you because all they do is offload on you and there's no exchange. This is a not good enough wounding. This is where you don't feel worthy of being an equal partner in the relationship. This is where you overgive of yourself for validation or for recognition, and it creates a codependency. Then perhaps we move on a little bit and you start to notice that that's happening, and that's when you become consciously incompetent. Okay, well, I don't really like this and I can see my part in it, but you're not really sure on how to shift and change it. And that's where you move on and you start to do whatever it is that you need to do in order to unravel the wounding that has given you the belief that you're not good enough. And that's when you're consciously competent. You have to really kind of keep your eye on the ball here. Now, eventually you get to the place where you're unconsciously competent, where that wounding sits within you. Because anything that's happened to you in your life is part of your own makeup, it's part of your energy, and you're not going to ever miraculously heal it. Now, lots of people out there say that you can overcome your not good enough wounding, and to an extent, I agree with them. But also, what I see is that every single time you decide to evolve your life, to expand your vision of who you are, to step up even more authentically and to speak more loudly, more visibly, that not good enough wounding will come and bite you on the butt because it's part of you. Your job as a human, as a spiritual energy living in your human existence, your job is to find a way to transmute the emotions that go with feeling not good enough, which is are less than, they're sadness, anger, frustration, is to transmute those feelings into love. Your job is to live through your not good enough, to understand it's within you and decide that you are on every single level of your evolution, of your expansion, of your living, of your being. Now, there is something that I see happen, and I'm going to talk a little bit about different things here, is that, you know, on every next step when your not good enough wounding shows up, it's really easy to not be available to that. It's really easy to just want to be happy, to push it away, to push it down and not pay attention to it. Especially if it got laid down in you when you were very small and it's difficult for you to articulate and communicate about. Now, ultimately, we all want to be happy, don't we? And happy is actually a feeling of connection. It's a feeling of being powerful, in your power, feeling of knowing that everything is yours. This happiness comes from being truly aligned to who you are. And if who you are at the moment is someone that decides or believes that you are not good enough, then we need to really go down into it and unpack why. Now, ultimately, not good enough means you're not connected, you're disconnected from yourself. And if you think about your spiritual self, your higher self, and your human self, which is your small self, and all of your conditioning, then if they are not kind of coming into alignment with each other, you are disconnected, and that's when you feel particularly not good enough. So chunking that down even further, not good enough is actually an existential wounding. Let me explain that. It's a wound of separation. So as you're born into our human world, your spiritual self has made the decision to come, and you come and are embodied and you are born. And as a very small, vulnerable baby, you gaze into your mother's eyes, and your mother's eyes are the universe to you. They give you a deep feeling of connection. Yet Your mother's human, as you are. Your mother is not the universe. It is not the spiritual whole which you have separated from. So sometimes she's got to put you down. And sometimes she's got to go away while you're crying. And this is the first unconscious wounding of not good enough. You feel separate. You realize you're separate. And in your separation from your higher self, you realize that you are confined. You're disconnected. You are not good enough. Now, this is very deep and it's very unconscious. And it's before you can communicate in any way apart from in crying. So can you imagine how that plays out in your life? Whenever you move towards wanting a deeper connection to feel more part of the whole, your deep unconscious, not good enough wounding rises up and tells you without words, tells you with feelings, tells you with learned beliefs, tells you with kind of feeling of constriction in your body, anxiety, frustration, tears even, that you are not good enough. And this comes back to separation from the spiritual soup, the spiritual consciousness to our human body. Now, I don't think that that is something that we need to call challenging, uncomfortable, difficult, whereas it is all of these things. I'm not saying it isn't, but I'm inviting the idea to reframe that so that as you feel these feelings of not good enough on whatever level you're at in your own exploration of yourself, that you decide the not good enough wounding showing up means that you're on the right track. It means that you are expanding. It means that you are moving more and more towards that feeling of being connected to your higher self, to you, all that you are in the universe. And I think, my belief and what I teach my clients is that not good enough is always the opportunity for a reframe. It's always the opportunity for growth. It's always the opportunity for more energy to flow through you. So from the vibrations of challenge of not good enough, which in our spiritual personal development world is kind of frowned upon and judged on, let's move into a vibration of ease and connection. Yeah. The not good enough wounding came when you were first born. It came when you realized you were physical, you were human. It came to help you survive in your small self as you grew. And as you grow into the understanding that you are all powerful, that you have choice and freedom, you get to choose to transmute all of the energy of your trauma, of your challenges, into a feeling of deeper connection to your higher self. After all, that's what we're here for, is to expand our consciousness into something more than we already know. And connecting with your higher self as much as you possibly can on a daily basis, listening to her, trusting her, following the signs, however they come to you, albeit a song that you want to that you listen that resonates with you and perhaps evokes tears, somebody that comes along and triggers that feeling of not good enough, thank them because they've come for a reason. They've come to help you release more energy so that you can feel more connected to your higher self. That's not going to heal the good enough wound. The good enough wound is a tool. The good enough wounding will stay with you through your life. It is part of who you are and is not to be pushed down, not engaged with, and decided that it's bad. Good enough wounding is an amazing opportunity for you to really feel who you are in this life. Now, I give you that live stream today because it's been coming up a lot for my clients, in that they are doing massive amounts of amazing work on themselves, but can't, that kind of shame themselves when they feel not good enough. And we all do on some level, you know. Even people that we revere as being super successful and maybe better than, they're not, they're just different, they're on a different path. They too have their own ideas of not feeling good enough that we don't understand. So have a little think about where you feel not good enough in your life. See if you can unravel that idea and your beliefs around it. Reframe it so that it's an opportunity for you to choose differently and to connect more fully with your higher self. And if you are interested in doing deeper work on this, come and talk to me. I have my Success Consciousness Mastermind starting in November, and the early bird finishes tomorrow. So it's 6 months of really wonderful shamanic journeying, deep, lasered, individual coaching in the group session, group setting, and continued weekly support all the way through our 6 months together. And we look at every single aspect of your psyche and connect you deeply, deeply with your higher self, your bigger dreams for your life, and all that you can imagine you can be. Think about living with the idea that even in your not good enough state, you are success by being alive, and you are privileged to be in your human body and to feel the feelings and emotions that you do. You are a conduit for the movement of energy, for the flow of energy. And that's what the universe is all about, transmuting energy from one vibration to another vibration and allowing its expansion and flow. And that's what Success Consciousness Mastermind is about, to harness that and bring it into your life for your business, your wealth, your absolute feeling of connection and ultimate happiness and alignment. So come talk to me. I will be putting the link for Success Mastermind in the comments and up above too. If you want, if you've got questions, put them in the comments or reach out privately. And if you want to talk about Success Mastermind, we'll set up a call. Lots of love, guys, and thank you so much for listening. If this resonates, please share it with whoever you can. Let's get the message out there that not good enough is not going away. It's not a bad thing. It's an amazing thing, and it takes you on to a feeling of deeper connection with yourself every single time. Okay, guys, bye.